Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making caramel icing. And the reason I decided to make it is that recently I did a cake for you, which was Black Tie Mousse Cake. And it was a wonderful cake, but part of it, the base, was one layer devil's food cake. So I made two layers and saved the other one, and here it is. And if you followed the recipe like I did, then you have a spare layer of cake, which is a devil's food cake. Now, I just wrapped this in plastic wrap and put it in the freezer because I knew I'd be using it very soon. I do have a cake plate over here waiting for it. And it's cold. I think it's lost its ice crystals, but it's been sitting out maybe an hour or so. And what I've done is to put some pieces of plastic wrap around underneath that can be pulled out, but I can be a little sloppy in the icing of it if I want to. So let me show you how to start this. You take a pot about like this, and you put one stick of butter in it. And I've already melted this just to save a little time, but it can go in unmelted if you like. To this, we're adding cream. Now this happens to be heavy whipping cream because it's what I had. It's 1/3 cup. If you have half and half, that would be fine. So 1/3 cup of cream of your choice. Also going in here is some light brown sugar. This is 1 1/2 cups of firmly packed light brown sugar. And then stir these together. At this point, we're going to take this to the stove. And we want to put it over medium heat. And we want to make sure that it comes to a boil. You don't have to boil it to a particular stage after that. Since this is very easy. It's not as hard as candy making. It's just making an icing, and the beginning step here is to get this boiling. So that's going to take a couple of minutes. Expect to stir this maybe a couple of minutes, then we'll come back and do our final step. So this is what you expect to get after boiling. And I just let it come to a boil, but it did take about 3 minutes or so to get to that point where it was actually boiling all over the top. Now the next step is to get a bowl that you don't mind using for beating. And I have my mixer here ready for beating. And what we're going to do is beat in 1 1/2 cups of confectioner sugar. Now that's the same as icing sugar or powdered sugar. And also I have 1 teaspoon of vanilla. So first I think I will just pour in this candy mixture and beat as I go. To beat this in, and I'll take a little break to put the vanilla in. Then I want to beat it to spreading consistency. Now here is the consistency of the caramel icing after I've beat in the confectioner sugar and vanilla. And you can see it's very workable. It might be a little runny. It is still warm. As it cools down, it will get thicker. So if you need it thicker, then just wait a little bit. You can actually put it in the refrigerator if you want to. But I think I'll go ahead and give it a try at this point. And I usually ice the sides first. And this is a very thin side to work with, so I'm glad I have my plastic wrap down. But I'll just go around, and if it gets on the plastic wrap, I'll try to bring it back up. And I'll make a thin cover for the sides, and then I'll go over it the second time, and then when I finish that, I'll be doing the top. Again, a thin layer on top, and then go over it again and get a thicker layer. So let me take care of that. It's just simply smoothing it around the sides and then smoothing it over the top. I'm just finishing up the top, and you can see the consistency that we have here. Now this has thickened up a lot, and when I started, it was a little bit runny. You probably saw that. That was because it was very warm. As it cools down, then you're gonna find that you have to keep moving or it will not be very cooperative for you. But you can just move it anywhere when it is warm. So I'm trying to give pretty even coverage, and I've pretty much finished this side that's toward me. There's just a few places to fill in, and you'll see that this is a very thick frosting for a one layer cake. That's because this amount of icing will do two layers. So if you have a cake that is two layers, this will be enough frosting. Or if you want to make more, you can do 1.5 times the recipe, something like that. So let's finish up, because as I put these swirls in, I can see that they're looking less pretty all the time because they're being dragged and making rough spots instead of being smooth. So I have a little bit left over. Perhaps Rick can take care of that. You think?
It's possible.
I didn't think there'd be any trouble there. So I'm going to bring my serving plate over here, and I'm going to use just a bread knife. Since this is just one layer, it's not a big deal. If it were like a three-layer or four-layer cake, I would be much more careful with the cutting of it. But it should be cool still, even though it had a warm icing put on it. And when it's cool, it's very easy to cut. Just go to the center with your knife and just slice straight downward. And the coolness of the cake is helpful in this instance. So here I'm making a wedge shape by moving over a little bit and cutting downward with the knife. And I have a cake server, a pie server right here. We'll go under it, try to get the tip. Got pretty much all of it. And we'll get this off onto our serving plate. And there we have our devil's food cake with caramel icing. Now I want to dress it up a little bit before I take a bite of it, so I'll show you what I brought along. A couple of months ago, I did a quick tip for you on making a sweetened whipped cream topping. It was kind of like Cool Whip, and I froze mine. I got this out probably 2 hours ago and let it come to almost room temperature. It's still solid in the center, so I'm going to the edge, and you can see that it has a nice look. You can use it just like Cool Whip or your own whipped cream, and this is my own whipped cream. And actually, since it's pretty much frozen still, if this is all I want to use, I can just take this spoon out, put the lid on, put it back in the freezer, and get it out some other time. Now, I'm not through with this. I would like to have something, and I bet you think I'm going to put either a maraschino cherry or some pecans on top. Well, I've got a little different idea. Rick and I like these bars, which are Dove chocolate, and this happens to be roasted almond, silky smooth dark chocolate. So that's what the bar looks like, and when you open it, it has three sections. I've taken one section, and I've used a chef's knife on a cutting board, and I have gotten some little pieces. So I think that would make a nice topping. I don't want to get too many, because that would overpower it, because I only have a small dollop of the whipped topping. I don't want this to fall off too much either. And I'm going to finish up by placing a little piece of mint. We still have mint growing in our herb garden, and I just went out a few minutes ago and got that, so it's very fresh, and it gives a good look to go along with the rest of our treat. Now, what we have done is to take some things that were in the freezer and use them up. We used up a one-layer devil's food cake, and we used up some of the whipped topping. And Rick and I have a lot of these candy bars, so we can spare those. And we used mint that would go to waste before the winter, probably if we didn't go out and get some occasionally and use it. So let me take a bite, and we'll see if it's any good. I have my milk over here waiting, And that's in my EKU class, one of them. That's Eastern Kentucky University, where Rick and I both spent our careers. And I'm going to go to the end and get some cake as well as some caramel icing. It looks delicious. The main thing I'm tasting for is the icing. It is so smooth and rich and tasty. I think you'll love it. If you like that flavor, this is really a good recipe for you to try. It's not hard at all. It's kind of a no-fail thing. It tastes so good. I hope you enjoy it.